Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? A few weeks ago, we looked at Messier 5, one of the best globular clusters to view from the Northern Hemisphere. And to me, late spring often means viewing globulars, as many of them are rising in the east when it turns dark. A globular cluster that rivals Messier 5 in size and beauty is Messier 13, located in Hercules. But first, a little about this mythological figure. Hercules, more accurately known as Heracles, was the son of the god Zeus and the mortal Alcmaeon. He was considered one of the strong men in ancient times, able to best any man with weapons of all kinds. But Zeus's wife Hera placed him under a spell. In order to atone for the crimes committed while under this spell, he needed to complete 12 nearly impossible labors. The first was defeating the vicious and monstrous Nemean lion, which had skin so tough no mortal weapon could pierce it. Heracles prevailed by strangling the beast. As his final labor, he defeated the serpent that guarded the golden apples. It is why Hercules is seen kneeling over Draco in the sky. We can find Leo the lion in the southwest about 2 hours after sunset, and Hercules in the northeast, with Draco nearby towards the north. However, these two constellations have dimmer stars than Leo does, but a handful of bright stars in the area can help us find the area for Messier 13. Begin by looking for slightly orange Arcturus, well up in the east, southeast. It is easily distinguished from bluish Spica and cream-colored Saturn, and it is slightly brighter than those two objects as well. Now look down and towards the east northeast for brilliant and very white Vega. One third of the way from Vega back towards Arcturus is the keystone shape that forms the chest or body of Hercules, though you may only spy three stars at third magnitude, as one of them is a dimmer fourth magnitude star. And now this week's dark sky fact. Want better sleep? According to Dr. Joseph Mercola, even the tiniest bit of light in the room can disrupt your internal clock and your pineal gland's production of melatonin and serotonin. Sleep masks can help, but updating our outdated and wasteful lighting in our homes and on our streets helps us all sleep better. To find Messier 13, locate the stars Zeta and Eta Hercules. Zeta is the brightest in the Keystone asterism and therefore the easiest to see. From there, use binoculars or a finder scope and head in the direction of second magnitude Polaris, but only move a very short distance, just about 5 degrees, under a full field of view. The slightly dimmer Eta Hercules is visible on the other side of the field, and in dark enough skies, or with a large enough finder, M13 may be visible as a faint, hazy round patch. Center this area in your finder scope or red dot finder, and start with medium magnification as an eyepiece. The cluster is 25,000 light years away and 145 light years across, placing it nearly as far as, but slightly smaller than, Messier 5 was. With stars as bright as magnitude 12, telescopes of 114 millimeters and larger can resolve some of its brighter members. Darker skies enhance the view even more. Even small apertures of 70 and 60 millimeters can provide a worthwhile observing experience for this object. Give it a try over the coming month. The dance of Jupiter, Venus, and Mercury continues this week, but with the unusual juxtaposition of Jupiter sinking quickly and Mercury rising rather speedily. By the 30th, the three planets are in a nearly straight line, though sighting a line from Mercury through Venus may be required to locate Jupiter. Saturn remains well placed from twilight through a couple hours past midnight. The last quarter moon occurs on the last day of the month, though early morning risers will get the best glimpse of our largest natural satellite. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.